One of the things that makes this coronavirus more dangerous is that it seems to be highly transmissible. And so even in people that don't show symptoms, they're able to shed the virus and infect other people. Our research began about a month after the labs were shut down. We applied for emergency funding through NSERC and were fortunate to receive two federal grants to study the coronavirus in our lab. There are many parallels between the work that I was doing on cancer before the pandemic and the work that I'm doing on coronavirus right now. My work previously was on identifying how these proteins on the cell membrane called receptors trigger cancer cells to grow and divide. So we've used some of the same tools that we have available to us to study cancer, to actually study how the coronavirus enters cells. So the first approach is understanding how the coronavirus uses a host machinery to replicate and then infect. Now, the second aspect of our research is called an antiviral strategy. Currently, there are no antiviral drugs that are approved for coronavirus treatment. But using drug repurposing, we can find drugs where there's known safety profiles that are Health Canada approved and use these drugs to treat coronavirus. The third element of our project is delivering precision medicine using these newly identified antiviral drugs. And we do this using a technology called ultrasound-mediated microbubble delivery. Microbubbles are injected as a contrast agent, similar to a dye when performing ultrasound imaging. What these microbubbles do, they oscillate and cause cells to increase the uptake of certain material. And so we can leverage this technology to increase the delivery of antiviral drugs. I love that I'm working on the cutting edge. We're working with an all-star team of Ryerson cell biologists, physicists, and chemists, but we're also partnering with SickKids in the Julian Lab, and we have industry partners such as Cyclica and Phenox. Ryerson's done a fantastic job of preparing me for the next step in my career. You know, as a postdoc, I'm in an in-between stage where I'm looking to develop my research program. And Ryerson supported that by having career development workshops. And also with the great work that I'm doing with Dr. Antonescu, who's put me into contact with expert collaborators from around the world. We have fabulous facilities, such as the facilities here at Mars. So it's a fantastic place to do a postdoc.